the rapid growing market of additive manufacturing is getting its growth number from metal and plastics today, but we are adding ceramics for the first time. The ADMAFLEX 130 is an exciting new product which is able to print high-dense ceramic components. We did install the first ones at our customers, which is great, and we got great feedback from these customers as well.
Well, what's different on our solution we developed is the way we are handling our high viscosity material. You can compare it to the viscosity of toothpaste, and you need kind of a system to handle this material on the printer. Well, we engineered a foil system to carry our high viscous material on our printer.
Generally, we know ceramics as a powder, and we actually use this powder as a raw material in our process. We mix it with a photosensitive resin, and we can use the resulting viscous material to build our components. A DLP engine helps us to build layer by layer through curing with light.
All the material that is not cured by the DLP light source will be pumped back through a filter back to the reservoir.
We overcame engineering challenges when we were looking into solutions for the investment casting market. Understanding the ceramic powder is a very important part of the process, and it allowed us to find and develop new solutions and applications. We are actually printing in aluminum oxide, zirconium oxide and fused silica, and the possibilities are almost endless.
Another unique item on the ADMAFLEX 130 is the user interface. We tried to keep the user interface as much as open, so the customer is able to change a lot of parameters within different print jobs and by using different materials.
The background from ADMAFLEX is strong in powder. One of the founders is a ceramic injection molding company. Another founder is an applied research institute. We had no idea about how to print, but we taught ourselves relatively quickly with the ADMAFLEX 130 as the first result. For the future, we see a need for bigger platforms. The ADMAFLEX 130 today is a production platform, but in order to beat probably shaping technologies as pressing or injection molding, we need to go to bigger platform size, higher productivity with the same precision as the ADMAFLEX 130 today. We're committed to this task. The big platforms are a task for our research persons today, and we need to get it done in the near future. ADMAFLEX does play a role on the additive manufacturing market today, especially for ceramics. This system and the ADMAFLEX 130, it makes me proud.